are making the tomahawk chop steak this morning. We've got one of the best restaurants in Kansas City in the house this morning. We're talking JJ's. And we do have a monthly series going on. We are talking with members of the KC Originals Restaurant Group, which JJ's is a member of course. They're all locally owned. JJ's executive chef, Julio Juarez, is here with us. Julio, it's good to see you.
Good to see you.
Thanks for coming on this morning here. We're going to make the tomahawk chop steak here. Yes. First, tell us about this cut of meat right here.
Yes, this is a ribeye, bone-in ribeye. It's like 50-something ounces, so it's like 3 pounds.
3 pounds?
Yes, 3 pounds of meat.
So when you at the restaurant here, do you serve it like this and do people share it all
together? Yes, this is for 2-3 people. So, yes, we're carving on the table. So it's something really nice. So we cook in a cast iron pan, and then we go to the table, and then we're carving in the table.
Oh, yes. My gosh, that sounds fantastic. Yes. Okay, so let's get started here. Let's season it up.
So the JJ's, we use just salt.
And is it coarse salt, sea salt? What kind of just?
Yes, coarse.
Coarse salt?
Yes.
And black pepper, of course.
We use black pepper, yes.
Now, is it important to coat all sides, or you just coat one side of it?
No, we coat both sides.
Okay.
Yes, it's very important, yes. You rub it all over, yes.
Get a good coating on there. Oh, and even on the sides, too, of course.
Yes, yes.
Perfect. How long have you been at JJ's?
For like 2 years.
Two years, yes. How you like it? It's the best, huh?
Yes, I love it, yes.
It's got a lot of history.
Great place, yes.
All right, so you're going to, once that's all together, what's next after the salt?
We use clarified butter. We use a skillet.
And the skillet is hot.
The skillet had to be really, really hot, yes.
See that smoke?
Smoking
right there?
Hot.
Nice.
Yes. Then we just drop in the pan.
I think I just breathed in some of that smoke. Now that's normal, of course, isn't it?
So we drop in a pan for like 3-4 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Nice sear on one side. We flip it for the other side. Nice sear on the other side, and then we drop in the oven for like 20 minutes for the medium red.
So I don't want to get ahead of you here, but it looks like you've got some thyme, some garlic, and what else do you have here, rosemary?
No, this rosemary, thyme, and the garlic.
And
garlic cloves. So after we have a nice, really sear both sides, we drop a fresh herbs. So this is the rosemary. So this, to give you really good flavor and aroma.
And they can do this at home. You can do this at home, right?
Oh, yes. It's really easy.
You know, my gosh.
All you have to do is just...
You can
we'll give you a nice sear. Nice,
that is amazing.
Nice sear,
this,
fresh herbs.
Just the smells coming
smell
off of that.
Really
that's
good.
Amazing.
So, and then we drop in the oven.
Drop it in the oven.
Mm-hmm.
And Julio has had one already cooking, which is super nice of him. And I'm really sad that I had to do this segment here because I believe Julio is going to... He's gonna plate it up. He's gonna have a little slice for me to taste here.
Yes. So, and then we just slice it, we're carving in.
Yeah, and normally, Julio, you would let it rest for like 20 minutes, right?
Yes, we let it rest.
Lock it in, right?
Yes.
That piece right there has got my name on it. I can see there it says, Nick, eat me. Oh my gosh. Julio, we're gonna chat with you in just a few minutes here.
Yes, sir.
With Mr. Francais. JJ's has been serving Kansas City for over 30 years, you guys. They are located on the west side of the Country Club Plaza. If you haven't been, you got to go.